You know, so just a really good overall game. Chris Brazel had some big catches for us. Chris Carter, that's the best game he's played since he's been here. You know, Mike overthrew him by a little bit on we got a little out and up play with the number three receiver. Now it's Chris down there near the goal line. He made a sensational catch to get the ball on 1 yard line for us. We had to play a lot of guys on the offensive line, and we probably played 7-8 guys, and they all did a really nice job. You know, on Yulkey's, you know, you never know. Sometimes you get a bunch of targets, sometimes you don't. Yulkey's touchdown, just a really tremendous block by Lawrence Keys, you know, and kind of sprung him loose. There's times when Yulkey has to do the same thing for Lawrence, you know, so a lot of unselfish play by our guys.
They hit you with quite the gut punch there. Three long touchdown drives back to back. I think often in there, that's pretty much your thoughts on the way you responded with back to back touchdown drives.
Well, we just weren't finishing drives in the first half. You know, I think we had 200 some odd yards, but it was a lot of it was between the 20s, and I went for one we didn't get, but just got to keep, you know, it's, I told him at halftime, you know, it was a 12 round fight. We fought six rounds. We got six rounds to go. You know, so you guys got to keep going. And the guys did it. And it's a good game to build off of, you know, as far as toughness is concerned. I thought they did a good job with that.
Keep calling 21-10. So they called a drop play, the tie that got the first down and ended up getting a touchdown. That's a play where you can start panicking and things aren't going well. He kind of stayed on schedule. What were your thoughts on that?
Well, he does a nice job of mixing things up. And we call that sequencing where we already know we're going to go for it. And let's get some of it. You know, and you can run it a lot. Oftentimes, you know, they're in. A three-man front, or they're thinking pass, and, you know, down schemes are really good against it. But if they get into something a little bit different, we have the ability to throw it out of that as well. So just it's a good job by, you know, Slade with the call and our guys executing play.
Would you feel like this sets you up going forward? Obviously, you know, you hadn't had much success in the state.
Last time the Tulane won here was 1998. And how old were you in 98?
One more year.
I knew that. But Tulane won twice that year. Mm-hmm. They won the Liberty Bowl and then they beat Memphis in regular season. So, you know, you can't carry over 1 year to the next. I'd say that all the time. And you can't revel in past successes. You're not going to be as good as you want to be. Or you can't pout if you don't play as well as you are capable of playing her, because you won't be as good that next week. So we move on and we go 1-0, and you know, each day, each practice, and it's easy for me to do. Sometimes it's tough for the guys, but they've really bought into it, and that helps you out. So that's one game, and then, you know, we got another big one. We're taking tomorrow off, which is good. Last week, you know, I told my coaches I don't want to see them in the office tomorrow. Last week we had a bye week, but we worked recruiting the whole time. So the kids had a few days off, but we busted our tails. So we're going to, you know, take it easy tomorrow and then jump into North Texas on Sunday.
Willie, do you ever think back?
Someone's saying something. You, Ed?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Coach, you ever think back to like a few years ago, maybe you couldn't win a game like this and you've kind of grown a lot as a program to make that happen?
Yeah, I always liked our fight whenever we played at home or away. We always competed, and we got better Jimmies and Joes right now. It's helping us with the playing. You know, we played a lot of close ones on the road against some real quality opponents, but we got some weapons on offense. You know, it's the first time I've had, you know, four guys on offense who can all run, you know, speed sweeps and run them effectively. Usually I have one guy. It's pretty easy to, you know, figure out who that guy is and all those kind of things. But we got a bunch of guys who can do it. There's a bunch of guys we can go to, like, you know, Chris Carter. You know, he stepped in, and a lot of times those balls are going to, you know, Alex Bauman, and, you know, Chris stepped in and played extremely well. And so we got more weapons, and we got good depth on defense. We rolled 9 defensive linemen in the game tonight, you know, and then we had a couple guys get hurt in the secondary. Lance Robinson was down a little bit. AJ Hampton stepped up. DJ Douglas got hurt. Kentrell Webb, who hasn't played much this season, you know, probably played 30 snaps today. And that's the first defensive action he's had this year. So we got more depth than we've had in the past.